From personal tilt-rotor aircraft to air taxis and flying cars, check out some amazing personal flying technology that might become the future of vertical takeoff. Number 10. The Vahana, also known as the AlphaOne. In January of this year, Airbus completed their first test flight on the Vahana, the first completely electric VTOL, or vertical takeoff and landing aircraft. Airbus has said it wants to build a fleet of autonomous multi-rotor eVTOL aircraft that can be used to fly from rooftop to rooftop in dense cities where traffic is often at a standstill. The company says it plans to have a production-ready version by 2020. Now, don't plan on flying in one of these with your friends. The company says it will be a single-passenger, self-piloted aircraft. Well, I guess that's not really all that bad. At least my friends won't ask for a ride in my awesome personal drone. No. Aircraft? Whatever it is, I think it's a pretty cool way to travel from point A to point B. Number 9, the Hero Flyer. We kind of came across this one by accident and thought, wow, this is pretty cool. There isn't much info out there on it, but it appears it was designed for the entertainment and marketing industries. Basically, an anonymous pilot wears the costume of a superhero, sports team, movie, or TV character, or any branded flight suit, and performs to the amazement of viewers at various venues, such as charity events, amusement parks, sporting events, conventions, grand openings, corporate events, movie premieres, and even commercials. Number 8, the AW609. This next VTOL basically takes science fiction to the next level. I know everyone has probably seen something similar to this, but imagine being a CEO for a company and instead of a personal helicopter, you have a personal VTOL. The Augusta Westland AW609, formerly the Bell Augusta BA609, is a twin-engined tilt-rotor VTOL aircraft with a configuration similar to the Bell Boeing V-22. It is capable of landing vertically like a helicopter while having a range and speed in excess of conventional rotor aircraft. The AW609 is aimed at the civil aviation market, in particular VIP customers and offshore oil and gas operators. Number 7, the passenger drone. So our last video we did on passenger drones got a lot of flack for the phrase passenger drone, which we're pretty sure we coined, by the way. Anyway, we just wanted to say, we told you so. Okay, all joking aside, this company has basically flat out named their passenger drone, passenger drone. What an original name. Seriously, think about it. It will be like Band-Aid or Kleenex. It's really pretty great branding. Their website says the aircraft is equipped with high-end technologies like adaptive flight control, fiber optic internal communications, field-oriented motor control, and encrypted communication channels. Their drone can take off, land, and perform all stages of flight maneuvering completely autonomously, guided securely via LTE 4G network or onboard controlled. They also say you can take over the controls at any time via the touch flight control or their fly-by-wire joystick. Number 6, the ZeroG. Although the ZeroG is still in a prototype phase, we still think it could be a game changer. The rendered images of their finished drone look pretty amazing. The prototype design made its first manned, untethered free flight test on November 4th, 2017, after about 10 manned tests were conducted in altitude hold mode. This free flight came after 6 months of unmanned, tethered flight testing, with some 50 flights made at a height of about 6 feet. All around the same time when other companies hadn't even gotten their drones off the ground. No pun intended. Number 5, the FlyCart. We have done videos on go-karts in the past. Hell, we have even done videos on the walk-karts, which is a water go-kart. but we have never done a video on a flying go-kart. The FlyCart is considered a mini personal air vehicle and was designed as a flying go-kart. The goal of the program was to produce a low-cost, easy-to-assemble and fly recreational aircraft that could fit in a one-car garage and provide hours of fun. I don't know about you, but when I was little, I used to always dream about flying to school. Weird to think about that kids in the near future might actually be able to do this. Well, given they are automated and the kids themselves aren't actually flying them. Number 4, the Scorpion 3. So before anyone says, you guys have already shown this one in another video, the answer is yes, we have, but this is an update for this awesome drone bike. I wonder if we can coin that phrase next. So what's the update, you ask? Well, apparently Hoversurf will be selling these awesome machines here in the US, and you don't even need a license to fly them. It's the closest thing to a flying car that has actually made it into production. And we think this actually might be better. Now, if they could only make a hoverboard. Like, seriously, guys, what is taking so long to make a hoverboard? Number 3, the Lilium Jet. Our next personal flying machine comes from Lilium. They have combined the idea of a personal drone with VTOL capabilities, and oh boy, is this thing amazing. Founded by entrepreneurs in 2015, Lilium is looking to combine the efficiency of an electric car with the vertical takeoff capabilities of a helicopter and the handling, speed, and convenience of a personal jet. They feel by combining these technologies, they could present a solution for urban areas that continue to grow more and more crowded. Using fans embedded in the wings, the 5-passenger aircraft can hover, land, or take off from a set position, similar to a quadcopter drone. Oh, and did we mention it's all electric? The aircraft's body houses 12 flaps, each of which house 3 electric engines. At takeoff, all of the flaps are vertical and creating lift. Once airborne, the flaps are moved to a horizontal position and the fans fold back into the wings so the jet can accelerate. They claim it can even reach speeds up to almost 200 miles per hour. Number 2, the Bell V280 Valor. Much like the design of the AW609, our number 2 is a tilt-rotor aircraft. These incredible machines are the future of aircraft and made strictly for our armed forces. Compared to legacy helicopters like the UH-60 Blackhawk, the new V-280 will fly at twice the speed and twice the range, and will have a medical evacuation coverage area 5 times greater than current helicopters. The Army had been planning, through its Joint Multi-Role Demonstrator Program, for 2 very different vertical lift prototypes to begin flight demonstrations last fall as part of a critical path to informing and shaping the design of a future vertical lift helicopter fleet expected to hit the skies in the 2030s. What do you guys think? Do you think these VTOLs could replace helicopters one day? Or is the ever so old design of a traditional helicopter here to stay? Number 1, EHang 184. The EHang has really done so much in the last 2 years. From Dubai investing in these for the first ever air taxis to being the first passenger drone to complete a real manned test flight. Of course, with anything new, people have their reservations. A lot of people are afraid of this method of transportation and think that they will fall out of the sky. Believe us when we tell you, you are not alone. But EHang 184 is the safest on the market right now. Most other designs require a runway to take off and land, and a pilot's license to operate. But that is changing. Developments in electric power, batteries, and autonomous flight systems have led to more people accepting the idea of flying cars or personal drones. The ultimate goal is a pilotless passenger drone that can either be parked outside your house like an ordinary car, or even summoned with a smartphone app like Uber or Lyft. With Lyft obviously being the more appropriate choice since you're literally flying through traffic.
Hey guys, this is Amber. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. You can help out by hitting the like button and also sharing with your friends. Have you hit that subscribe button yet? If not, make sure you do so. And while you're there, go ahead and hit the bell notification so you can be the first to see all of the latest videos. Thanks for watching. See you guys next time.